If you saw a cow along with that dolphin, we need to talk. Actually, not all stress is bad. Keep in mind that short-term stress can actually be a motivator. It's the long-term stress that demotivates, robs us of our energy, and actually can kill us. Picture your brain on stress like this big Sunday afternoon ham with cloves stuck in it like a pincushion. These are your stress receptors, and it's located in the hippocampus part of your brain. John Medina, in his best-selling book, Brain Rules, points out that we work well on short bursts of stress, a deadline, a sudden angry client that challenges our problem-solving abilities. It's the long-term stress that hits these receptors with cortisol, both in your brain and in your immune system. The double whammy, you're not thinking too well, and you don't feel too good either. Announcers at sporting events are fond of saying things like, he or she performs well under stress. Actually, no one performs well under stress. Great performers use stress as a motivator. The audience may be stressed as to whether or not someone gets a hit to save the game, but the 300 hitter is not. He has turned anxiousness and stress into anticipation. The two major combatants of stress are exercise and humor. Sapolsky's great book on stress, Why Zebras Don't Get Ulcers, explained that animals use short-term stress for fighting or running away. They don't have to sit on their butts in a conference room and pile up the stress by the hour. Stress for them is worked out through their muscles. So here's your action plan to get rid of stress. Use humor. Before you begin your phone calls today, find a funny video on YouTube or call a funny friend so that you physically laugh and talk about pleasant or fun ideas. Number two, use exercise. Get moving. Go for a wake-up run or go to the gym. Then start your phone calls. Have a great day selling.